this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's talk about crabs in a barrel. Okay, so I was talking to someone just the other day and I used the phrase crabs in a barrel, and the person I was talking to remarkably had never heard of the phrase before. So a lot of times we say crabs in a barrel or crabs in a bucket, and it's a very popular phrase, which means you're trying to raise your station in life and other people around you keep pulling you down. So I guess it is, if you were catching crabs and you put them in a barrel, you don't even need to cover the barrel, because when one crab starts to climb out, the other ones will pull them back in. And we talk about this a lot in society, in terms of if you live in an impoverished area and you're trying to make better of yourself, then a lot of times the people around you say, who do you think you are, and they will pull you back down. And a lot of times that happens if you're trying to do something special, like start your own business or go into apps as well. And there's a few specific examples I could think of in my life, and I'm sure you could think of some in yours too, when you're trying to do something that's a bit different than the other people around you. Right? One of them was, like, back in 2003, I started a blog. I thought, I want to start my own blog site. I just want to see what it's like. And I started doing a blog, and I did it for about a year. And then I was talking with someone who I worked with, and I said, well, I have this, you know, I've been writing this blog this morning. And his first thing was, oh, Eric, why do you need a blog? Right? Why do you need a blog? Right? And it actually put me on the defensive. Like, I was like, well, I just wanted to try it. I just, you know, I know it's not going to be very good, but I thought I'd try it. And I was like belittling myself, right? And it made me angry afterwards, because what he was saying was that I needed a reason. I needed someone to give me permission to do it. And that was just his mentality. It was like, you know, I was exactly the same as him, and I shouldn't be trying to outreach it, because he wasn't trying to outreach where he was. And it really, really bothered me. Another time was when I was working in a contract, and I already set up Overpass as a company, but I wanted to do it full time. I wanted to spend some time doing it full time, so I was in this contract. And by the way, this is one of the times I unsuccessfully spent about a year working on it and then went back into contracts. But at the time, I was having a conversation with one of my coworkers, and I was saying that my contract was coming up for renewal, but I wasn't planning on renewing it because I wanted to work on Overpass. I wanted to do my own thing. I wanted to set up my own company, and I had some ideas of some things I wanted to try. And he was telling me how it was destined to fail, right? He was just saying, I hope you realize it's not gonna work. I had a friend who, you know, he tried to make his own company and he completely failed or whatever. And he was in bankrupt and he, you know, lost his house, and had all these stories about why things wouldn't work, right? And I wish I could say that it didn't bother me. I wish I could say that I just ignored it all. But every time anything went wrong, that voice would come back to me. His voice would come back to me. Now, I met him years later, and he apologized for it. He says, you know what? I was wrong, right? But at the time, there were like a few years. And it's still, you know, when something goes wrong, that's the voice that comes back to you. It's the other people around you that, as much as you're trying to say, I need to raise my station in life, it's the people around you who make it difficult. And this is one of the reasons why I'm trying to spend more time with other business owners. Not so much to learn things from them, because you can learn a lot of things from a book, but it's just that mentality. You know, they're used to the same kind of things. You know, they're used to the same kind of problems, and you get into the same mindset. A lot of times they have problems that most people don't seem to understand, but you do. I was talking with somebody just this morning who has a small business. And she was saying how the other day just had a terrible day, so bad that she contemplated going back to corporate life, right? And I said, I've had loads of days like that. I've had loads of days where you just break down and you have so much pressing in on you on all sides. You have other days which are fantastic and you realize, hey, this is working, things are going great. But you have those other days where you start to doubt yourself, and those doubts creep into your mind, and you start thinking, you start realizing, it, you know, you feel like alone, because everybody can turn to you. You know, developers have problems, clients have problems, you know, family has problems, right? And everybody looks to you, and you can't look to anybody because you wanted to be free, right? So, and you start thinking, you know what? Why am I even doing this? And then, you know, you get into a better mood, and you realize, you know, the benefits of it all. For me, it's always when I contemplate going back to corporate life, it is that I play it through in my head, you know, oh, I'm going to go into somebody else's office, I'm going to sit there, I'm going to you know, go onto their computer, they're going to say, Eric, hey, here's your desk, you can go to lunch at 12, you have to leave at 5:30, and I was just, you know, the whole idea of it scares me to death. I can't believe I used to do that, right? You know, and I know a lot of you guys still do it. I hope you can get free also, if that's what you want to do. Yeah, but I probably work a lot more on Overpass now on my own, but it's on my own terms. So, but it's really good to have people around you who are in the same thing. You know, they say that you're the average of the five people you surround yourself with. And if you surround yourself with people who are in the same situation you are, you get into that crabs in the bucket situation where as you try to better yourself, they pull you back down. But it's not impossible. Sometimes, like doing the videos or doing apps, it took a while before everybody started to see that it worked. It took a while of doing a lot of things in secret or just pushing and being stubborn where a lot of people started to see, oh, maybe this is gonna work, maybe it is, and then you improve myself to them. But when it's in the beginning and you're the only person who can see it, it can be really, really hard. So today I just wanted to bring up that phrase, crabs in the bucket. And if you are brave enough, please put a situation in the comments where you had that same kind of thing, where you were trying to do something and other people around you were pulling you down, trying to say that something wouldn't work, you know, not being encouraging, but being very negative about it, because that happens, and it happens a little too frequently. But anyway, that is it for today. I'll talk to you guys again tomorrow.